আজকে আমরা প্রজেক্টাইল মোশন নিয়ে ডিসকাস করব। টুডে উই আর গোইং টু ডিসকাস দ্য প্রজেক্টাইল মোশন ইন সাম ডিটেইলস। অবভিয়াসলি আওয়ার ডিসকাশন উইল বি রেস্ট্রিক্টেড ইনটু দ্য থিওরিটিক্যাল কনসিডারেশন অফ প্রজেক্টাইল মোশন। লেট এ বডি ইজ প্রজেক্টেড উইথ সাম ইনিশিয়াল ভেলোসিটি ইউ মেকিং অ্যান অ্যাঙ্গেল থিটা উইথ দ্য হরাইজন্টাল। উই শ্যাল বি এবল টু সি দ্যাট দ্য ট্র্যাজেক্টরি ফলোড বাই দ্য পার্টিকেল দ্যাট ইজ দ্য প্রজেক্টাইল ইজ এ প্যারাবোলা। And obviously, we are here neglecting the air resistance and the other dissipating forces, air resistance and the other dissipating forces that are present in the medium. Okay? Now, so obviously, there is another important thing that the projectile motion is an example of two-dimensional motion under gravity. Two-dimensional motion under gravity. Okay? Now, so let us see that. Say, we are taken our reference axis, this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is the particle axis, and the body is projected with some initial velocity u, making an angle theta with the horizon. So, you all know, when a body moves along a curve, you can draw tangent at every point of this curve, you can draw tangent at every point of this curve, and this tangent definitely represents you, the direction of the instantaneous velocity of the projected body at that point of the trajectory. So, let the body is projected from the origin, that is 0, 0, with some initial velocity u. Okay. Now, this angle is theta. That is, the initial velocity is making an angle theta with the horizontal. So, u can be resolved into two components, two rectangular components. In this direction, it is u cos theta, and perpendicular to that, it is u sin theta. Okay. Now, let after t second, the body reaches at the point P. Let the coordinate of the point P, which is the point of the trajectory of the projectile, it is x, y. So in t second, the horizontal displacement of the projectile is x, while the vertical displacement of the projectile, it is y. Horizontal displacement is x, while the vertical displacement is y. Because this is x and it is our y. Now, as the body is moving under gravity and gravitational force is conservative, so it is worth mentioning that at every point of the trajectory of the projectile, conservation of mechanical energy principle will be valid. Conservation of mechanical energy principle will be valid. Mechanical energy means it is the sum of kinetic as well as potential energy. Okay, we shall see it later on. Now, after t second, the body reaches at the point P, and left at the point P, the instantaneous velocity of the projectile is p. Let at the point p, the instantaneous velocity of the projectile is p. Now, obviously, p can also be resolved into two components. One along this, let this angle is phi. So, along this, it will be p cos phi, and along that direction, it will be p sin phi. Along that direction, it is p sin phi. And along this direction, it is B cos phi. Okay. Now, the gravitational force is always acting, say, at any arbitrary point, the gravitational force is acting in the vertically downward direction. The gravitational force is acting in the vertically downward direction. So, the force of gravity, which is the only one force acting on the projectile, so the force of gravity has no horizontal component. Force of gravity has no horizontal component. That is, there is no force acting on the projectile along the horizontal direction. Or simply, according to Newton's second law of motion, there will be no acceleration of the projectile along the horizontal direction. Acceleration is zero along horizontal direction. It means that the velocity at every point of the trajectory along the horizontal direction will remain same in magnitude as well as in direction. I am again repeating this point. As there is no force acting on the projectile along the horizontal direction, so horizontal acceleration of the projectile will be zero because mg has got no component along horizontal direction. Because you all know from the preliminary vector conception that this angle is 90. So mg component of mg along that direction, it is mg cos 90, that must be zero. Or mg has no component along the horizontal direction. Okay, so no no force is acting along the horizontal direction. So there is no acceleration of the projectile along such horizontal direction, or velocity along the horizontal direction will not be changed. Acceleration zero, or there will be no change in velocity. Velocity along the horizontal direction will be same at every point of the trajectory. Will be same at every point of the trajectory. So you all see that at the, say for example, at the point P, the horizontal component of V, it is V cos phi. It is V cos phi. And the vertical component is V sin phi. Vertical component will get changed, because in the vertical direction there is an acting force. But horizontal component of velocity at each point of the trajectory will remain same. So we should have V cos theta equals V cos phi. And this is the equation. Okay, now after T second, the particle reaches at the point P. So horizontally, the velocity is not changing. So horizontal displacement is x in time T second, and the vertical displacement against gravity is y. Now we have put x equals to I shall have u cos theta into t. It is the equation number 2. And along y axis. Now let us see along y axis, the displacement along y axis. Now you all see from the figure that along y axis, the initial component of velocity, and that is mu sin theta. I have said that after t second it reaches at the point P. Then initial velocity is u sin theta. So y will be equal to u sin theta into t minus half t square. Very familiar equation, because you all know when a body is projected vertically upward, that is against gravity, the distance traversed by the body, and it is simply represented by h equal to ut minus half and it is square. Here u is replaced by u sin theta, because along the vertical direction, initial velocity of projection, it was not u but u sin theta. That's why I have written y equals to u sin theta into t minus half g square. Okay, now I want to find the relationship between y and x, eliminating t. Okay, because they are in the parametric form related with some time parameter. I want to write the equation, express the equation in between y and x. That is, I am going to derive the equation of the very much curve as followed by the projectile, which is known as the trajectory of the projectile. Now, from equation 2, you substitute t. So, t equals to x by u cos theta. Okay. Now, substituting the value of t, in equation number 3, we have y u sin theta into x by u cos theta minus half t into t square. T square means x by trajectory of the projectile. Clearly, it is the equation of a parabola, because you know that what I have got, y equals to somehow and tan theta into x minus g by 2u squared cos squared theta into x squared. Okay, but it is of the form, this equation is of the form, you all see that equation, I am giving it in a box. Okay, now this equation is of the form y equals to c1x plus c2x squared, where c1 and c2 are non-zero constants. Actually, c2 must not be equal to 0, c1 may be 0, c2 must not be equal to 0. I am writing as c2 must not be equal to 0. So, it is a familiar equation of the parabola. Okay, so the trajectory of the projectile is definitely a parabola. Okay, now the same equation can also be derived using calculus also. Same equation may also be derived using the principle of calculus. I am going to do that. Now before proceeding in the same way, let us find out an expression of the instantaneous velocity v, which is the velocity of the projectile at some arbitrary point p of coordinate x, y. Okay. Now, as I have already made concerned, or you must be confirmed of the fact that the horizontal component of the velocity of the projectile at every point of the trajectory does not change. That's why I have written u cos theta equal to v cos phi, because the projectile is only subjected to the gravitational force which is acting vertically downward direction. Okay, now after t second, its vertical velocity, you all see that initial vertical velocity was u sin theta, and after t second, the vertical component of velocity becomes v sin phi. Okay, now what is the relation between the two? You know from the simple kinematical relation that if a body is projected with a velocity u in the upward direction, that is vertically upward against gravity, then after t second its velocity v is given by v equals to u minus gt. I shall have to use of that formula. So after t second velocity is v sin phi, so I have v sin phi equals to u sin theta minus gt. This is our equation number 2. Clear? So from these two relations I can have a value of v. How? You just square the relations, and at squaring and adding we get v square into sin square phi plus cos square phi. It will be in terms of t, obviously, that is u sin theta minus gt, the whole square, plus u cos theta whole square. Okay, let's just wait a minute. So, okay, we'll come back. That is, or v square equals to, squaring the same, you will get u square sin square theta minus 2u sin theta into gt, plus v square t square plus u square cos square. What are you getting? Now, that is u square sin square theta plus u square cos square theta, simply give you simply u square minus 2u sin theta into gt plus v square t square. So, I am erasing the upper step. So, what are you going to get? That is, v equals to root under u square minus u square plus d square minus 2u sin theta. See, it is our equation number 3. So, if you are given the time of projection, that is, if you are, suppose you are asked to find out the instantaneous velocity of the projectile that is projected with some certain angle theta, that is, if the value of the theta is known, g is definitely known, it is generally taken as 10 meter per second square, or you may take also take its value as 9.8 meter per second square. If u is given, then I can easily calculate the instantaneous velocity of the projected body after t second, because you need to give the time, the required time after which its velocity is solved. Okay, so I can find the magnitude of the instantaneous velocity after a certain time of t second if u and theta are known. That is, you have to give him the initial velocity of projection and the initial angle with which the body was projected, with the horizontal direction. So knowing the values of u and theta and time t, you can calculate v. Okay. Now, you can also approach in some different way also. How it is so? Now, from the constancy of the horizontal component of velocity, we have got u cos theta. I am rewriting the equation 1 again. U cos theta, it is v cos phi. Now, at the point P, the particle is at a height of y. From the ground, at which its vertical component of velocity is v sin phi. I need not know whether v sin phi is acting in the downward direction or it is acting in the vertically upward direction. The problem, if I actually be able to solve the problem, the sign of the velocity of V sin phi or sin phi obtained on the basis of the kinematical equations will clearly show you whether it is directed vertically downward or it is vertically upward. That is, if I am able to solve the mathematical problem, then the sign obtained on the basis of kinematical equations, you will definitely get the sign of V sin phi and V cos phi, and that sign will indicate you whether it is acting in the downward direction or it is in the upward direction. So I need not bother about that. Okay. Now, it is the vertical height y. You all know V square equals to V square minus V. What this basic relation tells, you have already learned that if a body is projected with some initial velocity u in the vertically upward direction, in the vertically upward direction, then after traversing a height h, its final velocity becomes g. Okay? G is the acceleration due to gravity, then v square equal to u square minus 2gh. Negative g is taken because it is projected in the against gravity. That is, g is acting in the downward direction, u is in the upward direction. Okay. Now, I can use this relation here also. You look that the initial vertical component of velocity, it is u sin theta. And after traversing a height of y, the vertical component of velocity is v sin phi. So, I write it. V sin phi squared equal to u sin theta squared minus 2gy. And say it is our equation number 4. So using the relation 1 and equation number 4, I can also have a magnitude of V square, that is from which V can be obtained like that. So from 1, V square cos square phi plus V square sin square phi. Okay, you are getting u square cos square theta plus u square sin square theta minus 2gy equals theta. Okay, from relation 1 and relation 4. Now, here it is here. You are getting v square equals to u square minus 2gy because sin square theta plus cos square theta will give you 1. So, v equals to root under u square minus 2gy. And this is also a very much useful relation. Let's say it is equation number 5. So using this relation, if I am given the value of u, it is generally given, it has to be given if u is known, and if I am required that after some certain time or at some certain instant, the vertical height raised by the projectile, that is if y is known, then I can calculate v using this simple kinematical relation. Okay. Now, the same type of relation can also be obtained. Same type of relation can also be obtained using calculus principle also. Let us do that. In dealing with the problem by using simple calculus, I have to write the Newton's laws of motion. You all know that only the force of gravity is acting on the projectile. And there is no any other dissipative forces like the, I have already mentioned earlier, like the air resistance or other type of viscous forces acting on the projectile. So, what is the net force acting F? That is M. At any point, force of gravity is acting vertically downward direction. I am saying it is positive y. I have already shown in the figure also. It is positive y axis, it is positive x axis. So mg is nothing but mg minus j cap. It is directly along the negative y axis. So minus j cap, that is the unit vector along negative y axis, I have introduced. Okay. is Fx I cap plus Fy I cap. Because any two-dimensional vector can be resolved into two mutually perpendicular components. You all know from vector perception that is minus m j k. So comparing the same, now, first difference, that is m into m into dvx dt. So clearly, as m is not equal to 0, or dvx dt equal to 0, so we shall have dx equal to constant. Constant of time, constant with respect to time. Now, dx, you all know that is the initial component of initial component along the horizontal velocity. It was already u cos theta. Dx equal to u cos theta. Okay. So now again, dx equal to dx dt. It is u cos theta. Here I have also mentioned, or also assumed that you all know the horizontal component of velocity. I am again repeating this statement again and again. I have already said the horizontal component of velocity of the projectile at every point of the trajectory does not change, because along the horizontal direction no force is acting, or there is no horizontal acceleration. That is why the horizontal component of velocity will not change. Okay, so Vx, that is a constant, that is equal to u cos theta. Now again, x equal to dx dt. Vx is the x component of velocity, it is dx dt. So from this relation I have dx equal to u cos theta to dt. Now integrating. I am writing the upper step. Integration dx is x. Now u cos theta being constant, it can be taken outside the integration. U cos theta integration dt is t plus some constant c naught. Okay. Now the value of this arbitrary constant of integration are to be obtained from the some given initial conditions on motion. Okay, the value of the constant C1 are to be obtained from some given initial conditions already on the motion. For example, say let the body is projected from the origin, because it is our origin of the coordinate system. Let it is projected from origin. That is, at t equal to 0, x was 0, y was 0. So it is an initial condition on the motion. It is a given initial condition of the motion, and in type of such solutions you will get several type of integration constants, and all of them are to be found from some already prescribed condition on the motion, or from some initial condition imposed on the motion. You have to find those conditions. Now clearly, at t equal to 0, x equal to 0, so substituting that t equal to 0, x equal to 0, you will get C1 equal to 0. Now, what are you going to get? I am erasing this step. That is, x equals to only u cos theta into t. Now, let us discuss about the y component of the force. I have already got Fy equals to minus mt. Now, Fy means m into dvy dt. It is minus m. So, that is dvy dt, it is minus m. So, you can also conclude from this relation that along the vertical direction, or along the positive y-axis or negative y-axis, the acceleration is constant. Along the positive y-axis, the acceleration is obviously minus g. And along that negative y-axis, the retardation is g, as it is very much clear from the sign. Now, dvy dt equals to minus g. I am again using these two steps. So, dvy, that is minus g dt. Now, what are you going to get? The integration dvy. behavior is dy, it is minus dt plus constant spacing. It is the arbitrary constant of integration. Now, what is the initial condition of motion? You see that at t equal to 0, initially, the vertical component of velocity of the projected body, it was u sin theta. That is at t equal to 0, dy was u sin theta. At t equal to 0, it was u sin theta. So substituting this condition here, I get u sin theta. Therefore, I shall have dy equals to minus dt plus u sin theta. A very much familiar equation also can be obtained from simple kinematical relationships. V equal to u minus dt of the formula. Now what is vy? It is dy dt. It is minus dt plus u sin theta. Now, I have to find out y. Or dy, u sin theta, minus dt, dt. Integration process. What are you going to get? Integration dy is y. Now, first integration u sin theta dt, it will give you u sin theta t minus. Integration dt dt, g is constant, it can be taken outside the integration. Integration dt dt means t square by t. Plus some constant of integration system. Okay. Now, again, from some initial condition of motion that the body was projected from origin, that is at t equal to 0, y was 0. It was also 0, I have already used of that condition previously. Now, at t equal to 0, y equal to 0. That is, substituting this condition over here, we are getting 6t equal to 0. That is, y equals to u sin theta. It is minus half t squared. I have already obtained x equal to u cos theta into t. A few minutes ago, x equal to u cos theta into t. So from here t you can substitute, that is x by u cos theta. So substituting the value over here, I am getting y equals to u sin theta. X by u cos theta minus half t x by u cos theta. Y equals to, that is, u cancel, sin theta by cos theta is tan theta, tan theta in x minus gx square by 2 u square cos square theta. Trajectory of the projectile. Okay. Up to this, I am returning back after a few minutes.